So I'm getting ready to prepare some oxtails for tomorrow's dinner. This is about 8 pounds. I have them cut. I don't like them cut too small because, you know, by the time you cook it, then there's nothing left to eat. So about this thick. And basically, I'm going to wash them with lime. You can also use vinegar, but I'm using lime to wash my oxtail. And I have them trim all the fat off. Squeeze some lime in here. Wash it really good. Rinsing it so you get all the blood off. I'm gonna put it in another bowl, piece by piece. Make sure we don't have any excess water. Thank you. Okay, I'm going to use some oxtail seasoning. We Jamaicans, we don't measure stuff. We just eyeball stuff. And these seasoning contain a lot of sodium, so I'm not using salt at the moment. My husband and my kids don't like hot stuff, so usually we would use like Jamaican Scotch bonnet pepper, but I'm using red pepper flakes. Not too much. And of course, Maggie all-purpose seasoning. Paprika. And garlic powder, of course. And some onion powder. And we're using browning to give the meat some color. Not too much, because you're going to brown the meat itself before cooking it. And I don't like to use my hands, so I'm using a fork to coat the meat. Because if I feel like I need to add a little more seasoning, I don't want to be touching meat and then touching my seasoning container. That's how you contaminate stuff. So this is why I use a fork. Or you could use a spoon. Or you could put gloves on. Whatever suits you. This is my kitchen and this is my way. See, the browning gives the meat a little coloring. I'm gonna put some more oxtail seasoning. And I'm gonna put a little adobo in there. Now I'm going to put in here, I have fresh thyme, fresh scallion, lots of fresh garlic and onions. You could put whatever you want to put in your oxtails. You can put peppers, like red bell peppers, green peppers, and all that. I am going to add some tomatoes in it when it's almost finished cooking, but not now. I think I forgot the black pepper. Can't forget that. Let's keep mixing. Just coat everything evenly. And I'm gonna have this marinate overnight in my refrigerator. And tomorrow I'll show you guys the finishing touch. I'm gonna add tomatoes, some ketchup, butter beans, just before it's finished cooking. So have a good night. See you tomorrow. I have my oxtails here that I've marinated since last night. Now I'm going to brown them up in the pan. So what I did, I removed all the seasoning before you put them in the pan to be brown. Don't put too much because the oxtail has its own fat on it. You know, we try to trim them as best as possible, but still end up with fat on it. So you put your pan on over medium heat. And you just put them in piece by piece. Just like that, let them brown. Let's put another one in here. I'm going to brown them all up, and once they're in the pot to be cooked down, it takes like 2 hours to cook. I'll come back and show you guys that step. So the oxtail has been browning, and this is how we Jamaican like it to look before we actually start cooking it. So I will come back and show you once it's in the pot to be cooked. Okay, the oxtail is finished browning. Now I'm transferring it from this pan. We're going to leave all that oil behind. Put everything in here. So we're just going to switch the pan. What I did was add some water to the seasoning, like around 4 cups of water. And I'm just gonna put everything in here with the seasoning. That's how I do it. Most people put the seasoning in after the oxtail is cooked. But I feel like, what's the point then? I feel like the seasoning need to cook with the meat to give it flavor. Understand? And then after it's finished cooking, or almost cooked, I can add whatever else I want to add, which I will add more stuff. Just give it a nice stir. Make sure everything is, trying to get the seasoning to hit the bottom. And this is going to cook for probably 2 hours, hour and a half, 2 hours. It depends on the tenderness of the age of the cow, I suppose. You know, oxtails came from the cow's tail, so it depends on how old the cow is. I feel bad. Oh well. Maybe I'll become a vegetarian before I die, but that's how I was raised, to eat meat. Oh, that's looking real good. So I'm just going to cover it. Put your heat on medium low and just let it simmer down. Over here I have some water. I'm going to make some rice and beans. I use Grace coconut cream. And I'm going to use all of it because I like my rice and beans to be nice and have that coconut flavor. I'm just using a spoon to get it all out. Scrape out as much as you can. I'm using black beans. You could use black beans, you could use pigeon peas, you can use whatever beans you want to use. Growing up in Jamaica, we used to use kidney beans a lot, but I like black beans. So just pour the whole thing in there. I have fresh garlic. I already washed them. Fresh thyme is already washed. I have scallion. Scallion is already washed. I have like 4 teaspoons of butter. Well, it's margarine, but you can use butter if you wish. I'm just going to tip a little salt in here. Black pepper. Onion powder I use. And this is garlic powder. Gonna give it a nice stir. I usually like to put a green pepper in it. The green pepper gives it Scotch bonnet green pepper, but I don't have any. I run out. Like I said, we Jamaicans, we don't measure stuff. So we just eyeball stuff. Gonna give it a taste. It's good, so I'm gonna let it boil up so the coconut cream could dissolve in it. And the scallion and the thyme and the onion, the garlic could boil up. And then I'm gonna put some rice in. Okay, I have 4 cups of washed rice. I washed my rice a couple times so the starch could, you know, come out of it. So I'm putting that in here. I'm trying to get every grain in there. Yeah. And I don't use a fork to stir the rice. I use a spoon. Look at that. So this is how we make rice and peas, or rice and beans. I don't measure anything. I just kind of, you know, use my like I said, when we Jamaican cook, we don't measure anything. And after you've been cooking for a while, everything just comes naturally. Okay, so I'm just gonna turn this on medium low so the rice can cook. And I'll show you the finishing touch. Our oxtail is still going over here. All right, see you guys soon. Okay, our oxtail has been cooking for approximately 2 hours. Now I'm just gonna add some tomatoes, green onions, and some butter bean, and just let it. I using Grace butter bean. I washed and rinsed them. I love a lot of butter beans in my oxtail. Just trying to get everything evenly. Oh, look at that. Getting in the pot, son? Are you getting in the pot?
Yeah.
I want the people to see. Looking good. And I'm gonna let that simmer for like 10 minutes. I'm about to show you the rice and beans. Nice. All right, see you guys in 10 minutes. Cover that up. Okay, guys, our oxtail is ready. And our rice is ready, rice and beans. So I'm gonna make a plate. It's a little bit, I don't want too much. Some butter beans. Look at that. I love butter beans. Okay. I'm just gonna have this with some shredded cabbage and carrots and peppers. You could have it whatever you want. We usually have with steamed cabbage, but I'm tired of steamed cabbage, so that's what I'm having it with today. Okay, until next time, one love.